the borough of Queens. We're at the home of the Mets, City Field. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Oakland A's and the Tampa Bay Rays.
And now, your 2021.
We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Josh Harrison stands in, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 1-1. Hit on the ground out to short. He's got it. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. So one out and nobody aboard, and that'll bring up Starling Marte. Swing and a little blooper to center. Kiermaier coming on, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
That is first. The first baseman, Matt.
So now to the plate, Matt Olson. Pitch out, nothing doing. Marte, base runner at first with one out. Marte off for second. Pitch swung on and missed. The throw is not close as he's in there with a stolen base. The 2-2 pitch. Popped him up. Wendell has room in foul territory, and that's the second out of the inning. So here's the Oakland cleanup batter, Mark Canna, for his career in this matchup. He's 1-for-5. The 1-1. That changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Back up the middle, and that's through into center field. Base hit. Marte is on his way home, and he's safe at the plate as they take the lead. The tag, and they'll get him at second, and with that, the side is retired. Now to the plate, here is Brandon Lau. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And the count will be full. 3-2 pitch. And another foul ball. Count is full. Here's the pitch.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Not shortstop. Wonder.
Just hung in there on that one. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And that brings up the corner infielder, G-Man Choi. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. Rwanda Olson will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Seth Brown. The 2-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. On the move is Kiermaier. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. So bases are empty with one out now, and that means Matt Chapman will dig into the plate. A 1-1 home. Taken below the zone for a ball. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. A full count, three balls and two strikes. Now a swing and a miss. He struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second. Base is empty, two away, and that'll bring up the big time power bat of right-handed hitter Chris Davis. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him. One and two. Ran it in on him as this is bounced toward short. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. Second set to go, and next the dangerous power threat, Nelson Cruz. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Into the windup and the pitch. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. Now at the plate here is Austin Meadows. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number two. So next to bat will be Randy Arozarena to try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Now the 1-1 pitch. A bouncer up the middle. And the Rays are into the hip column with their first hit of the contest.
The third baseman.
And now Joey Wendell. Pitch misses low. The throw down. Skips in and he's safe. Close play, but he's in there. 2-2. Here it is. Ball three. 3-2 now.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
And the stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. So stepping in is Tony Kemp as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. And he looks at one in there, 1-2. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. So next to hit is Sean Murphy. Now the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a line drive. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's working full now at 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And now it'll rattle up against the wall. Around second now and headed for third. The relay throw. Well, he is in there with a triple. Into the box, Josh Harrison. 2-2 the count. From the stretch. On the ground, softly towards second. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the run comes in to score. So two out, nobody on. And that'll bring up Starling Marte. Swing and he pops him up. This is right out in front of the mound. And Zunino will put the squeeze on this one to retire the side. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Mike Zunino.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Two balls and a strike now. All even now, 2-2. The pitch. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
You do not want to walk the eight-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the nine-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
And nope, good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
Batting ninth.
And the now in the box, Kevin Kiermaier.
Kiermaier.
Lifted the other way out to left center. Left fielder is on the move. He's not going to have a play on it, and this might bring home the runner from first. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
Now back, second baseman, Brandon Lau.
To the plate now, Brandon Lau.
Now,
off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1. Wander Franco waits on deck. Full count now, 3-2.
Hey, there's a ton of reasons I could give to you as to why this guy has been such a good pitcher in his career. But I think this is the biggest one. His ability to work out of nasty jams. Two guys in scoring position right here. Interested to see how he works out of this.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Catch is made here in right, and here comes the runner from third. And they are on the board with the sac fly as this is now a 2-1 game. That brings up Wander Franco, a potential tying run for him at third base. This one's flared down the right field line, and this is going to work out for him. It's a base hit, and they'll tie the ball game as the run scores, evening things at two.
The first baseman.
Throw over to first.
Dive,
but he's back. Standing in now, G-Man Choi. And it's 1-2. And this one gets away. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. Hit hard down the line. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. From the stretch. This is on the ground over to first. Fielded cleanly, and he'll take this one to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
Now
and that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. Runner in scoring position with Sugan. Ready with the 1-1. Line drive to center field. Base hit, and that'll get a run in.
Now back, left fielder, Austin Meadows.
At the plate, Austin Meadows fouled away. Ready with another 2-2. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Kenna gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. New inning set to get underway, and that brings in the big power hitting first baseman Matt Olson. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. No one on with one down. And striding into bat next, it will be Mark Canna. Now the 3-2 pitch. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. High and deep to right center. Right fielder giving chase. He takes the turn and heads for second. And that will hop over the wall now as he'll be awarded second base here. It's a ground rule double. So now to the plate, Seth Brown. And there's ball two now. Swing and a ground ball to third. And that's the second out. So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman. Base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Ready with the 2-1. Grounded to short. Throw in time and the side is retired. Bottom of the inning now, and next will be a speed thread in the form of outfielder Brandy Arozarena. And he misses two and one. Hit on the ground to third. Chapman brings it in, and that's the first down. One out here in the Tampa Bay fourth. And digging in next will be Joey Wendell. A 3-1 pitch. There's ball four. So a runner at first with one out now. And that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. Here's the 2-1. Trying to move the runner into scoring position here, but this is a foul ball. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. And the throw will come to first, so the sacrifice works as planned. Digging in next, Kevin Kiermaier. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
But a little unlucky there as it's hit right to him in right field for the final out of the inning. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And digging in is the veteran DH, Chris Davis. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Two balls and two strikes, the count to Chris Davis. Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field. Kiermaier is there and he has it for the out. Now to the plate, Tony Kemp. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Smoke toward the hole. A dive and he knocks it down. On the recovery throw is in time to get the out at first. What a heads up play. Into the box, Sean Murphy tripled and later scored first time around. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Hits are now even at four apiece. Lined hard toward right center. But he will run this one down in right center. A tough L9 and the inning is over. So Tampa's batting order turns over and set to go. Brandon Lau as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. 2-1 pitch as a sinker swung out and missed. 2-2. And it's fouled away. Now a cutter, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Wander Franco waits on deck. And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway. Next up is Wander Franco. Singled homer run in his last time up. One and one, here it is. Changed up on him and dropped it in for a called strike. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's two and two.
Well, that sinker is normally a really important pitch for him, but it really hasn't been effective so far. It just looks kind of flat.
Struck him out, so he set down on strikes for the second time today.
The first baseman, G-Man Shore.
The 1-1. Taken, strike two. Still a ball and two strikes. The next 1-2 pitch. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two.
Now batter.
Next to bat will be the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Nelson Cruz. He delivered an RBI single in his last trip. Here's the 1-1. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Now a move over to first, and the runner back safely. Fifth inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Full count, 3-2 to the Rays DH.
Well, this has been a good at bat. He's now worked the count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with two away.
And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move the runner into scoring position now with two away. Yanked hard but foul to the right. The set. And the 1-2. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring up Josh Harrison. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. Digging in next will be Starling Marte. He singled and later scored back in the first, making him one for two so far. There's a shot out to right center field. On his way to second goes Marte. And he'll reach second now with one away. In now, Matt Olson. Let's see what they throw Olson on a 3-1 count.
Well, that's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Josh Fleming takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. Mark Canna will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. So 1-1.
No, that's down.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Now the 2-1. Even count, 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Is laid off and the count runs full.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
And indeed, he'll not even try as he goes to first, and that means two men are in scoring position now with two away. Now it'll be Seth Brown trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The set and the 1-2 pulled toward right center field. No trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. James Caprillion enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 32.
Stepping up is Randy Arozarena. He bounced out last time up. Swing and a liner. Kenna is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first out. Now at the plate is Joey Wendell. It was a walk in his last trip. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike. 2-2 now. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. On deck, the big bat of Mike Zunino. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Another full count pitch home. And he pops him up, drifting toward the left side of the infield. Making the play here is Harrison, and there are two away now. So here's Mike Zunino. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. Pitch on its way now to Zunino.
2 balls, 1 strike, the count.
Squared that one up just a little late. 3-2 is our score here in inning number 6. Zunino, a drive. That's out to deep left field. Looking up is the left fielder, and this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. Into the box, Kevin Kiermaier. Now a swinging bunt.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Gets him looking, strike 3. Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Matt Chapman. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Nope, outside.
And there's a missile off the bat, but it's foul. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Shot to first, and there's one away. Chris Davis next to bat. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here now the 2-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Here now the 2-2. Missed down low in the third, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And that misses as Davis will reach. It's ball 4. The 1-2. Slowly hit to first. I don't think they can get two. Scooped up. One there. But one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue. Andrew Kittredge takes the mound now, and it appears he's being brought in to face the right-handed batter who waits next.
Yeah, you usually don't hear the term righty specialist very often, but that's kind of how they're using him here, Matt. Most hitters have a harder time against pitchers of the same handedness, so we'll see if this move pans out.
To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. At the plate now is Brandon Lau, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. fouled off. Another full count pitch home. The bouncer to the left side. Chapman has it cleanly. And the throw on to first will take care of him. So he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away.
Number five.
Up next, Wander Franco. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, Maddie, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play. Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Now in the box, G-Man Choi struck out in his last trip to the plate. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Again, he sends it out of play. Four runs, five hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Oh, and he hammers it to deep right field. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. Here's Merrill Petit. Takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning. Into the box now, Nelson Cruz. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Here comes the 1-2.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
He'll try again, 1-2. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. All set for the start of the inning, and the ever versatile Josh Harrison digs in. It's 2-1 to the A's leadoff batter.
Hey, even though this guy's a righty hitter, he's going to get pounded with that two-seamer. He needs to make sure he catches this thing out front if he sees that pitch again.
Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Here's Starling Marte. It was a two-bagger for him in his last at-bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Stepping in now, Matt Olson. 2-1 to the A's first baseman. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Speared on the dive. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. Fouled away. Again, a 1-2. Hit back toward the mound. And close play at first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one. Now to bat, Randy Arozarena. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And that misses, 2-1.
Oh, that's a tough call for Blue right there. Either way you call it, somebody doesn't like it. But hey, that's the life of an umpire.
Oh, and he gets a fastball up in the zone, and he hammers it out to deep left field. And this baby is gone. A home run. Standing in now, Joey Wendell. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Yeah, you ain't kidding, Matty. Dan, what does this feel like when balls are just flying out of the yard?
D-Row, it's just one of those days when you're out there as a pitcher going, oh, I wish I was somewhere anywhere else but on that bump right now. This has the makings of being a long game.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Now batting.
Here now is Mike Zunino. Blasted a solo homer last time up. 1-1. Misses for the second ball. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants.
We'll have to press pause. Is that strike three to retire the side? Set to start the ninth in this one, and striding into bat next, it will be Mark Canna. The 2-1. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Kiermaier looks up. Gone to lead off the inning. Peter Fairbanks takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door.
Number 29, Peter.
At the plate, Seth Brown. Now another one hit deep to left. Meadows moving back to the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And that'll bring in Matt Chapman. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks. And even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
And that one yanked just foul. Swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with.
Now
next will be the designated hitter, Chris Davis. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Last strike now for Oakland. And a swing and a miss as they definitely had him reaching for that one, and this ball game is over.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
6-3, the final score today. The Rays led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Ryan Yarbrough is credited with the win. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ball game: for the victorious Rays, 6 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Athletics, 3 runs on 7 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base.